Welcome to the Bacteriophage Plaque Assay Virtual Laboratory. Here is what you will need for your experiment. You will need 1 milliliter glass pipettes, pipette tips, 5 petri plates containing media, a pipette pump, a pasture pipette, and a micropipetter, 5 vials of 2 milliliter tryptone soft agar, phage stock, E. coli culture, and 9 milliliter aliquots of tryptone broth along with a Bunsen burner. To begin, take a pipette pump and a pipette from the pipette stand. Fix the pipette to the pipette pump. Take the phage stock culture from the test tube rack. This contains the bacteriophages that we will be using for our experiment. Now, we will perform a serial dilution. To do this, first remove the cap of the tube containing phage stock culture. Heat the mouth of the tube in the blue flame of the Bunsen burner. Take 1 milliliter of the culture from the tube using the sterile pipette connected to the pipette pump. Flame the mouth of the tube once again. Recap the tube. Place the phage stock back on the rack. Now, take the tryptone broth tube marked 10 to the negative 1. Remove the cap of the tube and flame the mouth of the tube in the blue flame of the Bunsen burner. Transfer 1 milliliter of the cell culture from the pipette to the tube. When you are done, flame the mouth of the tube once again with the Bunsen burner and replace the cap. Mix the tube properly before placing it back on the rack. Now, remove the used pipette and dispose of it properly. Fix a new sterile pipette to the pipette pump. Now, take the tryptone broth tube marked 10 to the negative 1 power and remove the cap of the tube. Flame the mouth of the tube with the Bunsen burner flame. Take 1 milliliter culture from the tube using the pipette. Flame the mouth of the tube once again and replace the cap. Now, we take the tryptone broth tube, marked as 10 to the negative 2 power. Remove the cap of the tube and flame the mouth of the tube using the blue portion of the Bunsen burner's flame. Now, transfer 1 milliliter of the culture from the pipette to the tube. Flame the mouth of the tube once again before replacing the cap on the tube. Mix the tube properly before placing it back on the rack. The same procedure is repeated for the rest of the broth tube, labeled as 10 to the negative 3 through 10 to the negative 10. Each time, a new pipette is used. When you are done, remove the cap of the tube marked 10 to the negative 10 power. Flame the mouth of the tube using the blue portion of the flame of the Bunsen burner. Remove 1 milliliter of the culture from the tube using a sterile pipette. Flame the mouth of the tube once again. And recap the tube before placing it back on the rack. Discard the 1 milliliter broth to a beaker. Next, we will prepare our plates. To do this, we open the lid of the water bath and set the water bath to 100 degrees Celsius. We'll place 5 tryptone soft agar tubes, marked as 10 to the negative 5 through 10 to the negative 9, into the water bath and then close the lid. The water should be at a level just above the agar in the tubes. Allow the agar in the tubes to melt for 5 minutes. When you are done, maintain the temperature of the water bath at 45 degrees Celsius until the completion of your experiments. When you are ready, remove the lid of the water bath and take out the soft agar tube labeled as 10 to the negative 5th from the water bath. Then, take a sterile pasture pipette and grab the E. coli culture tube. Remove the cotton plug from the tube. Heat the mouth of the tube in the flame of the Bunsen burner. Take a small amount of the culture from the tube using the pasture pipette. Heat the mouth of the tube in the flame of the Bunsen burner. Recap the tube and place it back on the test tube rack. Now, take the soft auger tube labeled as 10 to the negative 5 and add 2 to 3 drops of the E. coli culture to the tube. Now, replace the cap. Take a micropipette and adjust it to 100 microliters. Now, open the tip box and fix a fresh new tip to the micropipette. Now take the tryptome broth tube labeled as 10 to the negative 5th. Remove the cap of the tube and using the micropipette, take 100 microliters of serially diluted phage stock. Replace the cap and mix the tube properly before putting it back on the rack. Take the soft auger tube marked as 10 to the negative 5th, remove the cap, and then transfer the 100 microliter serially diluted phage stock taken from the 10 to the negative 5th tryptone broth. Mix the tube properly. Take the petri plate marked as 10 to the negative 5th. Open the petri plate. Now, open the tube containing the mixture of soft auger, E. coli culture, and serially diluted phage stock. Pour the contents of the tube into the petri plate. Recap the tube. Close the plate and gently shake it to spread the auger evenly over the bottom. The same procedure is repeated for all of the other soft auger tubes kept in the water bath. 2 to 3 drops of E. coli is added to each of the soft auger tubes at different concentrations. Then, 100 microliters is transferred from the tryptome broth to the soft auger tubes. Then, each of the soft auger tubes is poured onto its own petri plate, properly labeled with its concentration. Then, we incubate all the petri plate cultures. They are incubated for 24 hours. After 24 hours, we can take out the plates from our incubator. Keep the plates inside of the hood and observe the results. You should notice that the more dilute samples yield less plaques.